General timetable for Forge of Empires. It starts so simple with just a tiny village and the plan to develop it through the various ages. And then there are so many things coming to a player. Technology tree, province map, great buildings, daily challenges, events, guild expedition, cultural settlements, GVG, and the newest feature, guild battlegrounds. Which of these are important? What should I use as a new player? What will be the best order and what to do when? How fast should I advance through the ages? This video wants to provide answers on this. In the technology tree, you research technologies which consumes forge points, coins, supplies, and eventually goods. Some technologies enable special features of this game. This already happens first in the tutorial, when the technology Spears releases the province map. Generally, the province map should not be neglected. You should always conquer the provinces of your current age. In the lower ages, this can be done without fighting bonuses. Often, it is possible to conquer the provinces of the next age, which you should do then. The technology construction releases a friend's tavern. This tavern will be very important in a later stage of the game. In the beginning, you invest only here. This means that all silver coins you collect there are reinvested in upgrades immediately. The tavern should reach its maximum, which will not last very long. Afterwards, you can spend the silver coins for interesting bonuses. Along with the technology cultivation, you get access to the events. Approximately once every month, there is an event in Forge of Empires. This always is a long quest line, an integrated minigame, and interesting rewards, especially the event buildings. I highly recommend these events to all players, but especially new players. Nothing else can accelerate your development as much as these events with their great rewards. The quests are very simple in the lower ages. You definitely should not miss this. The main prize of each event is a building that in relation to its size provides more benefits than every normal building. The most important decision will have to be made when you research the technology smithery. Along with it, you get access to guilds. Deciding for the right guild is extremely important for your further development. Some guilds have special requirements, example given participating in guild battlegrounds every day. Others concentrate more on supporting each other and trading. Of course, you should check the type of guild and this must match a player's expectations. Deciding for the right guild is the key to be successful and a good foundation for having a lot of fun in this game. Guild members can then participate in the guild expedition. I highly recommend to use that opportunity every week. You should fight as long as possible and afterwards you still can continue with negotiating. The rewards, including the in-game premium currency diamonds, makes it worth. As negotiating is expensive, you will want to fight as much as possible. To support this, you will need the fighting bonus coming with the great buildings Statue of Zeus, Cathedral of Aachen and Castel del Monte. Also, the Alcatraz and the Temple of Relics are very helpful in that setup. It is recommended to move forward through the lower ages relatively fast, especially if your guild will not be able to help with missing goods and blueprints for these great buildings. The investment in these great buildings is most beneficial for new players as the great rewards of the guild expedition pay back everything very fast. Older advisors recommended the Lighthouse of Alexandria. I only consider this for players who dislike fighting. This I would recommend only for those players who don't want to fight at all. Everybody else should invest forge points concentrated in these great buildings with battle support. Then fight the guild expedition every week, and when you cannot fight anymore, then start to negotiate as much as possible. Best case, until the end of level 4. At the beginning of the Iron Age, the technology architecture enabled the great buildings. From now on, you collect blueprints. In the beginning, you simply store each blueprint that you can get. In the Iron Age, you don't have many different great buildings anyway. It will still take a while until you can construct your first own great building. Also, at the beginning of the Iron Age, along with the research of the technology militia, the daily challenges are released. These are a feature for players who can spend more time in this game. Even beginners will be able to complete the daily challenges and to receive the great rewards. But you also can ignore these completely to concentrate on the more important parts of the game. Along with the technology military tactics, the PvP feature will be enabled. From now on, you can not only attack other players, you also can be attacked by them. Whatever you might try, you will not be able to defend against attacks coming from players who are already developed much better. A successful attacker can plunder an unmotivated building. Simply accept these annoying plunderers as unavoidable blows. They will not really hurt the development of your city. You will be able to afford such small losses. At the same time, the guild battlegrounds will become available. You can access these via a building in the northeast of your city. I can recommend for all players to do at least a few battles there every day. Only as much as your barracks can support. Every fight supports your guild a little and you gain fighting experience. At the end of the Iron Age, with the release of the technology plowing, you will get access to the cultural settlements. This is another optional feature designed for those players who can be online several times every day. These cultural settlements construct a second village that will not remain continuously. In return, you will receive attractive rewards. For completing a settlement, one reward is guaranteed, and the other one will be granted only if you meet the attached deadline. Players who cannot log in many times every day should not get irritated by the deadline and simply complete that village using as long as it might take. Take your time. This is a game, and it has to be fun, not stress. The question that I receive most often is about the speed of your progress through the ages. Is it better to remain in an age to develop the great buildings? Or is it recommended to move forward very fast? For new players, I highly recommend to advance swiftly at least until the colonial age. These ages are designed to teach all necessary game elements and to get the required training. This is a great foundation for further decisions. And there is no right or wrong for such decisions. The game provides a lot of possibilities and you can decide for the possibility that fits best. The recommendations I gave above only increase your further possibilities. How to use these is your individual decision. It is very important to understand that all game elements are simply optional offerings. There is absolutely no pressure to use them all and always. Nothing bad will happen if you will not participate in an event, if you ignore cultural settlements or daily challenges, or if you take a break of 3 months. Afterwards, you can continue where you paused. This is one of the great strengths of this game and makes it so much compatible with your real life. This game is not dominating you. We all play when we have time and have a mind to do it. Most of the topics in this video have their own videos in this channel, which I recommend to get more detailed information than. Today, I simply wanted to provide a first overview. Especially the veterans of this game often cannot imagine how confusing these many possibilities can be for new players. I hope that today I was able to help a bit in that specific situation.